rain earlier, but the sun is back out. And we have two of the best women's soccer programs in the country. Number 20, the Colorado Buffaloes, the home team, and Washington State, number 7. Both of these teams unbeaten coming in. The Cougars, the only unbeaten, untied team in the nation at 10-0, and the Buffaloes 9-0-3. Thad, we've got a fantastic matchup. I can't be more excited for this one.
First ranked opponent for the Buffaloes this season. They've not played a top 25 team yet. They're playing one that's firmly in the top 25. Now their best ever ranking in program history. Cougars at number 7 in the polls, Colorado at number 20. And you mentioned it, unbeaten, 10-0, in fact, of 5 unbeaten D1 programs in the NCAA. Washington State, the only one without a tie either. So this is a completely unbeaten, untied, 10-match team, the Cougars.
The Buffs working it in deep here, and it's going to set up a corner. You're talking about 10 games. They've done as good as any team can imagine. You've got 10 matches. You've got 10 wins for the Cougars, but the Buffaloes very good here at home, 5-0-1 at Prent Tubb Field. Aaron Greening, number 16, is heading into the corner to take this kick. Buffs setting up with a little pressure early.
It'll be those details like corner kicks early on to see who establishes offensive supremacy, and the Buffaloes get one in the corner right at the top, and they put a goal away right off the top.
Just like that, the Buffs are in front. A minute 21 into this one. My goodness, that's how you want to start things off. If you're the Buffaloes, get on the board early. Buffs fans loving it here as Taylor Korniak from Aaron Greening right in the opening couple of minutes. Just like that, a corner kick, and it's in the back of the net.
Wow, great ball from Greening, who returned from injury. Korniak, who just returned from injury herself. They both missed a chunk of games, and they pair up 1:21 into the clock against the number 7 ranked team in the country. The Buffaloes coming off of a double draw weekend in Arizona, having drawn with Arizona and Arizona State. Buffaloes wanted to establish himself
there. She was moving deep into the box there. I can't imagine that was the game plan, was to not mark her at that height, 6'1". She's the main target almost every time in these corner kicks, these set pieces.
Well, a redshirt junior goalie for Washington State, Rachel Thompson, the current Pac-12 goalkeeper of the week, had a great week last week, selected as the Pac-12's goalkeeper of the week, and immediately surrenders a goal.
Heading the other way now. The Cougars got a great offense themselves. So we got two high-powered offenses. That gets all the attention when you look at it. Both teams averaging over 2 goals per game as Greening is down right now. Aaron Greening, number 16, had the assist, the senior from Piedmont, California. She's getting some attention from the referee. Robbie Huller is our referee today. Greening back up on her feet, but she went out against Colorado State very early on in the season. And she has been back. It's great to see her back. Returned against Arizona State, but certainly need her out there along that back line if you're the Buffs.
Aaron missed 8 matches, came back against the Sun Devils. Ball right in front of the goal again, and Barton's going to clear that out for now for the goal just scored. Taylor Korniak, her 4th goal of the season and the 2nd assist of the season for Aaron Greening.
This one's sent behind the net there. It's going to be another corner. Maddie Harrow, 19, senior from Corona, California, will take the kick. She also has 9 assists. When you look at through the game notes, that you think you see Taylor Korniak, oh, she's way up there in assists. And then all of a sudden on the other side, Maddie Harrow also right there. So they're tied in assists, although Korniak already has a couple of points here today. This one sent in the middle of the box. Korniak heads that one out of there.
On those 9 assists, that is number 2 in the NCAA. They are tied, Harrow and Korniak, with those 9 assists for the 2nd most in NCAA soccer. Of course, leading the Pac-12 with that 9 assist mark. And an opportunity there for Harrow. So a corner for the Buffaloes converted into a goal. And Washington State can't match that on the other end. How about J.J. Tompkins?
She has been fantastic. I'll tell you what, What a keeper. I mean, you're talking about a career save percentage, career goals against average. Number one in program history here is we got a whistle. This is going to go against the Cougars. That's Morgan Weaver, number six, a junior from University Place, Washington, one of the best players on this Cougars team, especially offensively. But Tompkins, she has been fantastic. The redshirt junior from Phoenix, Arizona, a captain, and as we talked about with those numbers, career goals against average and save percentage, number one in CU program history.
And currently number five in the NCAA this season, 907 save percentage. That's the fifth best mark in college soccer. That foul that was just issued, if you look at game style, it's sort of strategy employed by both of these programs, pretty clean game, really pretty athletic game that they both play. For the Buffaloes this season, seven yellow cards, no red, and for Washington State, five yellow cards, no red. Likely to be a, you would think, based on what we've seen so far this year, a pretty open flow game where you're gonna see a lot of athleticism, a lot of movement, not a lot of kind of grinding it down and mucking things up. And of course, that's when you've got talent like you have on the pitch today, you wanna see them run and open things up a little bit. So we'd expect, we saw a goal right out of the gates at 121 in, we'd expect fairly intense high-speed match.
And if you're watching at home, obviously that you gotta love the sound of that, what Thad's telling us about, because these are two highly skilled programs, and obviously the rankings demonstrate that. We're talking about Pac-12 soccer here, so certainly the Conference of Champions, and certainly a lot of talent on the field. It was displayed early, but you mentioned it, Thad, there's a lot of firepower out here. So the one marker on the board right now for the Buffs, I don't think it will be the last here today.
A lot of firepower and also a lot of Cougars. 30 players on their roster. Take up an entire plane on their flight out here for the mountain trip. They'll play at Utah on Sunday as Colorado will host Washington on Sunday. But 30 people, and 19 of those are underclass. They've got 19 freshmen and sophomores. Fourth-year head coach Todd Schulenberger, so he's kind of now filling in. You know, you kind of prime the pump when you start your career. It takes a couple years to get your players in. He's still got 19 of 30 players as underclass. I asked him before the match, 30 players, how do you manage that? That's a lot of moving parts. He said, yeah, we might have gotten a little greedy in recruiting the last couple years, but we had so many good kids. The other thing that speaks well of for Washington State is they land their recruits. Because I asked, I said, did a few more kids accept than you were assuming would? Or some kids not leave the program when you took over? And he said, I don't know, but it's working great. We're happy with it. They got 30 on the roster.
A big roster. And there's a number of Cougars. We saw them in the parking lot doing some tailgating.
Yeah, they brought a little crowd.
They keep traveling down from Pullman, Washington.
Well, Washington State has four Colorado kids on the roster. And that's, I was talking to Coach Schulenberger about it. And, he said, I said, what are the states? What are they? Because Colorado's a great club/prep soccer talent state, right? And he said, oh, absolutely. And he said Texas, California, Colorado kind of in one breath. I said top five state in the union for soccer talent. He said, oh, without a doubt. And he went straight to California, Texas, and Colorado. So you got four Colorado kids on this Washington State roster, including some freshmen. Gracie Armstrong, a freshman at a Legacy High School, which is just over there. You can probably spit to Legacy from here in Broomfield, Colorado. So Gracie there, Sydney Pulver out of Regis, Brianna Alger out of Lewis Palmer as Tompkins picks one up. And they also have Micaiah Minnis out of Doherty High School, who graduated out of Doherty last year. So a couple of freshmen, a couple of sophomores from Colorado on the Washington State roster.
Minnis, defender, only Cougar to play every minute this season, center back. And as a freshman jumping in, a little Hannah Cardenas, effect there. And getting back to that Colorado as a hotbed, every team that comes in here, you see it. There's a lot of California teams, obviously, that come in as far as the Pac-12. But every team that comes in, there's Colorado players all over the roster, because no matter how far away it is, they're recruiting up and down the front range in particular here. There's so much talent. And Coach Danny Sanchez, of course, trying to keep the best ones here. This one's sent across. It's in deep. It got punched out. A couple of players went down. It got flicked on. And the defense able to clear it out momentarily. But
I see you Kinzer's keeping the pressure on.
Yeah, Kinzer headed that ball right back up.
And Jorian Bauckham had an opportunity in the middle. And Bauckham is explosive. She's quick. She's dynamic. Just about saw her strike from close range.
And somehow we've gone almost 10 minutes, Thad, and we haven't mentioned Tatum Barton's name yet, the junior from Littleton, Colorado. 11 goals on the season, 24 points. A huge offensive threat for the Buffs.
Second most goals in the NCAA this season, Barton. Header comes across and the follow by Bauckham. Boy, Buffs putting on some great offensive pressure, Brad.
Massey keeps it in. And finally, the Cougars able to relieve some of that pressure, but Greening moved up here, able to control it. Sends a ball back in, trying to find Korniak off of her head, but well defended there. Now Thompson gets wiped out. Barton's going to be the guilty party there as Thompson is down. Rachel Thompson, keeper from Alaska.
That will be a yellow card, but, you know, there are certain kinds of yellow cards. That was a good aggressive play by Barton. Ball was loose, and, you know, she did get a little extra something at the end of that, I guess. But, okay, so on the second look, Tatum took an opportunity there. She did pick up a yellow card. Pretty nice play in low by Rachel Thompson. Thompson took over for Ella Diedrich. The senior, the redshirt senior, was injured against Idaho for Washington State, one of the top goalkeepers in the country, unable to go this season for Washington State. Yeah, pretty good job by Rachel Thompson, the redshirt junior, of picking up and carrying on. She won a Goalkeeper of the Week award. But interesting, I was talking to Danny Sanchez about this. You know, all good goalkeepers are quick to just credit their defense, and both of these programs, Cougars and Buffaloes, that's what it's all about. They have great goalkeepers, but you're not a great goalkeeper if you don't have a great back line. And for all the talent we're talking about, the cork in the back here for both of these clubs is stout.
Yeah, two real anchors here defensively as Barton's trying to run onto this one. It's played back to Thompson. She tries to send it out of there. Massey has it, trying to keep the pressure on. And you're talking about two great communicators as well when you're talking about these goalies, and that's part of it, certainly crediting that back line, but you've got to be in constant communication with that back line, and everybody's got to be on the same page. It's all part of it, and these two goalies, great communicators. Tompkins, intense, full of passion out there.
Yeah, and I love, as you say that, I look over at J.J. Tompkins, and, you know, the ball's at the other end, and she's down here barking out instructions. I was off headset for the Colorado State match here early in the year, so when we're sitting here, you can't, you know, you don't hear her as well. That match, I really got an appreciation for the communication and positivity out of Tompkins in goal.
There's a juicy rebound here for Bauckham. She's able to put it in, a flick of the right foot, and it's in the back of the net. 2-0 Buffaloes.
Relentless pressure from Colorado, overwhelming the Cougars early in Boulder. Washington State comes in ranked number 7, the highest ranking ever for the program. Of course, coaches downplay that. They know this is going to be a battle, and Colorado, known for early goals this season, for piling up some points early in matches, and they do it here with a couple. They got one from Korniak, and now Bauckham on a mess in front of the goal. Thompson got laid out, the goalkeeper. Great work by Bauckham as she adjusts, goes back to the right foot, and sends it home. And there's a mishandle, and that was the key. But Bauckham, you're not going to survive that. She had 33 goals in her 3 years at LSU. She has carried on at CU as a scoring dynamo, and the Buffs go up 2-0 on the Bauckham goal.
Bauckham, 9 goals this season, 42 in her career. And she came in third among active players in the NCAA in career goals with 41. Now she's up to 42. And you couldn't ask for a better start if you're head coach Danny Sanchez and your Buffs. You got this high power offense attacking from the very first second this match started, from kickoff. And within 13 minutes, 12 plus minutes here, they've got two tallies on the board.
Smorgasbord of stats, you know, which in soccer isn't always the case, you know. But if you're covering the Buffaloes this year, you get this buffet of statistical fun you can have. The Buffaloes came into today with 34 goals on the season. That was the second most in NCAA soccer, one behind Mercer. They're now ahead of Mercer. They've already scored two in the first, you know, 13 minutes of this one. So 36 goals on the year.
That one ruled not a goal. Tompkins couldn't handle it. It was right at her, but it came off of her hands.
Hit the crossbar.
And then Bount went down. Even it had a chance with some spin off of that. The entire bench and sideline for Washington State. Up off the bench here, want an explanation.
There's a new Buffalo I'm a big fan of, as is Danny Sanchez and all Buffalo's fans. Emily Grork went down. She was fouled. The freshman Grork out of Missouri got her first collegiate goal at Oregon State. Grork, another dynamic addition to the Buffalo's program. Well, that was a tough ball for Tompkins. It slid through her hands. I mean, that would have been a misplay. We had a misplay on the other end from the Cougars goalkeeper, Rachel Thompson, that let Bauckham score. Buffalo's again threatening.
Barton fighting for it there in the box. This got sent out of there, but now along the sidelines here in front of Danny Sanchez.
We were asked before the match, Brad. The officials just stopped by and said, hey, do we have replay review over here? And we don't. I think that probably would have borne out that was not a goal. But it was close. it was right on it.
That was Megan Massey ripping one with a big left foot. That one just over the corner of the goal. Let's take another look at that last attempt. Mm. And based on that bounce, hard to say whether it was all the way across that line.
It's not hard for me to say.
It was partially, at least.
Good look, Buff Vision. Eric Poloni directing today and also catering and whatever else he does.
He does it all.
Nice job by our camera crew. Pretty good look there. And I think Cougars had an argument.
Definitely an argument at the very least.
They're down 2-0, and you don't see that much out of Tompkins either. She created an opportunity there off the hands and dodged a bullet. But it's hard to get in. You keep trying to get in a couple thoughts on the Buffalo's offense, and their offense keeps interrupting those thoughts because they're attacking the Cougars.
Yeah, look out here as Korniak goes down. That time that ball got sent back out. Morgan Weaver. Leading score, 14 points for the Cougars. Plays it up ahead. Webb with a nice play to stop that. Elise Bennett had that ball into the box for the Cougars, but Haley Webb, the freshman, able to make the play.
Good to see Erin Greening moving around pretty well. Don't see any limitation in her movement. Of course, after missing time with an injury, after the injury in the CSU match, and then earlier here she was down near the defensive end line for the Buffaloes. Just an update on that. She looks like she's moving and playing as you would hope she would be with the follow-up to that ding up she had earlier in the match. So we're talking about that CU offense now, 36 goals on the year. And they already set a program record with 40 assists before today. They had 35 was their previous high, done four different times, including last year. They've already surpassed their season assist mark, set a record there, and they've added to it today. And this offense with those 36 goals, they have the number one or number two goal scorers in the Pac-12 in Barton and Bauckham.
Corner here, this one's bent into the box corner, going up high, and she got cut down. And that foul's going to go against her. A little too aggressive flying in for that one. Taylor Korniak,
Taylor
guilty party.
Listed at 6 feet, 1 inch tall. And, you add to that leaping ability or athleticism. I mean, she is head and shoulders above everybody on these opportunities. What a weapon for Danny Sanchez, the attacking midfielder. She, with those 9 assists, she had 4 assists in the match against Missouri. That set a record for the Buffaloes for single game assists. And that's what you love out of a face of a program player. She dishes it as well or better than she scores it.
She got the Buffs on the board earlier today in the second minute, and that's when we were watching that replay, you're going, I don't know if that's what the Cougars had in mind. She had a little bit too much room to run on. Now, this last ball, she got, she was marked tightly and ended up committing the foul, being too aggressive, but that's probably what the Cougars wanted to do in the second minute when she was able to get that corner and get her head on it and put it in. She had a little too much room to step into that one, or walk into that one, I should say, and put it in the back of the net. I do want to go back to one point, Thad, that you made. 36 goals as this one's put in again. Stopping the offense. Here's another chance. That one got deflected. It's not cleared out of there. And this call is going to go against the Buffs. We've talked a lot about the offense, as we should, historical season so far, for not just as team and individually, but on the flip side, they've given up 5 goals. Mm-hmm. 36-5 on the season. Are you kidding me?
Well, Washington State's right there too defensively. These two are the finest defensive programs in the conference. Of course, most of that through non-conference play. They've each played 3 conference matches now, and but the bulk of that work, and Danny Sanchez said that to me earlier, the Buffalo's head coach, he said, you know, a lot of the work we did and the numbers that you see, it's a result of non-conference. It's not going to look like that moving forward. You get a Pac-12 play. And the Buffalo saw that on the road last week in Arizona. I mean, it's a grind and a fight every time out. Goals are at a premium. I'll be honest, as good as these two programs are, you know they're offensively capable. I'm shocked it's 2-0, and it's been 2-0 since the 11:35 mark of the match. I mean, I didn't expect Colorado to come out and pump two goals on the board quite that quickly. A great start for the Buffaloes. This one's coming to you, Brad. Play it out.
I might make a play here. It's off the tent.
If we wouldn't have had the tent today, you could have headed that.
Yeah, could have sent it right back in play.
That does continue our season-long streak of damage to the broadcast position in every Buffalo's home match. So that damage brought to you by whatever insurance company. Name one.
We'll take them all.
No, don't name one.
I was steering clear of that.
Unknown insurance company.
We do have a great seat over here, a beautiful facility at Prentup Field. We should mention, although you see the sunshine, there was a downpour about 2 hours prior to the match. Pretty heavy storm and a lot of rain, although it wasn't very long. The length didn't include a ton of precipitation, but there was heavy rain when it did come down here. And they water the field. They water everything here Prenta beforehand, so I'm not sure it's going to play a huge factor on this grass surface, but we'll keep our fingers crossed for no more of that type of weather coming through here. But there was some rain coming through early, a couple hours before kickoff.
I was here for the Missouri match this year, and there was a lightning delay on that one. It was about an 88-90 degree day, blue skies, some lightning happened back over the Flatirons, and of course they go to the 30-minute protocol, and you have to have certain distance of clearance from lightning strikes and all that. So yeah, today I thought, oh, here we go again with another delay. But last time it happened, it was to the Buffs' benefit. They scored three goals in the first 12 minutes and change against Missouri after a lightning delay. They struck quickly after that one. Today's weather was not looking at all pleasant. Now it turned into a beautiful day. Temperatures dipping down, I think upper 60s, low 70s. It's kind of where we're gonna end up today. It was about perfect. Won't be long before, both these programs in the NCAA tournament last year. In fact, Washington State for the first time ever made the third round last year, got two wins in the tournament. How about the complete turn in the season, college soccer season? You start off here in 90 some degree weather. By the time you're done, you're playing in snow. And Buffalo's hoping to be playing in snow again this year.
It's part of a fall sports, right? The fall season when you're in the NCAA tournament. You're into winter at that point with some snow and rain, but they'll take it. That's where they want to be playing. That's when you want to be out there. But certainly different conditions than you start the season off and go through all that training and preseason. And you're out there sweating before school even starts. And then next thing you know, you're in the NCAA tournament. These two programs ranked 7th for Washington State and 20th for the Buffs. Certainly headed there again.
Cougars have made 6 of the last 7 NCAA tournaments. They missed in 2016. Buffalo's missed in 2015. They've been in 4 of the last 5 tournaments, Colorado. But for Washington State, this is their highest ranking ever. They're in 6 of the past 7 NCAAs. They made the third round last year. And this is an impressive buildup. Todd Schulenberger, 4th season. John Harvey, a 5th-year assistant coach. Greg Sheen on the staff. And the Cougars have a win over UCLA already this year on the road at UCLA, a 1-0 win. They beat UCLA last year at home in Pullman 1-0. Actually, Coach Schulenberger said, last year I thought we were the better team. We won 1-0. He goes, honestly, this year I thought UCLA was a little better team, but we did what we had to do to get the win.
This one available in front there. Tompkins eventually covers it, but some dangerous times for that Buffs defense is two great opportunities for the Cougars.
Elise Bennett, the sophomore, was loose in the middle for Washington State. She was very active against Oregon State last Sunday, was Elise Bennett. She had an attempt that rebounded to O'Neill for a goal. And then Bennett was also taken down by the goalkeeper on the attack, and it set up a free kick for Haro, who scored. So Bennett didn't score against Oregon State, but she really created both opportunities. She was looking point blank on that last one. She's a dominant force in the middle for the Cougars as Elise Bennett.
Bennett, 3 goals, 1 assist, 7 points on the season. Sophomore from Wisconsin, 5'10".
I appreciate Molly Myers out of Oceanside, California, the freshman. She wanted us to check her in. We sent her on to the right authorities.
We sent her towards midfield there. She'll get checked in.
Also, Ebony Clark going to come off the bench here, the freshman from British Columbia. So Cougars got a couple of subs waiting on the side.
Bennett applying some pressure there. Buffs trying to get it out. They get it to midfield. Bauckham to Massey in the midfield.
It's fun watching Bauckham handle the ball.
Here's another look at that one. Off the near post. Tompkins again diving and covering the goal. He made it to the post.
So a couple of times the framing has come into play for Washington State. Once off of the crossbar on a Tompkins deflection that was a mishandle by JJ.
Korniak could be whistled there for the foul.
Well, Taylor, her senior year at Coronado High School in Henderson, Nevada. High school senior year, 54 goals, 12 assists that year. She's the Nevada Player of the Year. That was a handful of years back now. She's a junior here in Boulder now, but 54 goals in a season. That's pretty fun.
That's unheard of. That's crazy. This year, 4 goals to go along with 9 assists, 17 points.
And she added that one today. Korniak started the scoring, assisted by Greening. There's Jesse Lauren. That's another freshman. What an impact. I was talking to Coach Sanchez about Jesse earlier today, and she's been another, you were talking about kind of those rocks in the defense, those stalwarts back there, and especially young players. You get these freshmen. Lauren, she got a goal earlier this year, but her calling card has really been keeping that defense sturdy, especially with Hannah Cardenas gone. Man, I love watching Jesse Lauren play.
It's really impressive when you talk about some of these freshmen that come in and the impact. They're highly recruited. We know the success. You talked about Korniak and the success she had in high school. But you look at this back line right now, you've got Kaylee Webb and Jesse Lauren, two center backs that are both freshmen and both anchoring the defense there, obviously with Tompkins back there. But it's impressive to see those. You had Cardenas last year playing all 22 matches as freshman at center back. So Danny Sanchez has a lot of weapons to go to, a lot of pieces, the versatility that he can go to, and Lauren and Webb are two big parts of why this defense has only given up 5 goals on the season.
A couple of California kids enjoying their time now in Boulder, and the machine, you know, really, same for Washington State, the machines are running. This is reloading time now for both programs. Great job establishing such a presence in the game. And you know, the club background of Danny Sanchez and Dave Morgan on staff and Jason Green on staff and Todd Schulenberger, no different. He spent a lot of years in club soccer. Coach Schulenberger was in the Atlanta area for a long time. And I was talking to him earlier. He's a Pennsylvania kid.
Robert Morris University.
Did big work in the Atlanta area and in club soccer. And you know, once you have those roots established, it kind of doesn't matter where you go. Buffalo's again in some trouble here.
Webb tried to clear that one out, and then Weaver got a big left foot at it.
Well, here's what happened earlier for the Cougars of Washington State. They're down 2-0, and let's get another look at this ball off Tompkins' hands up to the crossbar.
If the crossbar comes down. Looks... It's either all the way in or partially in. Could it be? It has to be all the way across the line.
Yeah,
now.
Everything
has to be across.
Great, that's great camera work. And what you cannot see is green between the ball and the white line. There might have been. I would assume on review that would be an inconclusive, and that would be not enough to overturn the call that was made. Looked like it potentially had some white line on it.
And again, yeah, we can't tell for sure. Obviously, it wasn't reviewed. So that's it's going to stand as called. No
right,
question
not,
about that.
Yeah, we're reviewing it because
our,
we have the benefit of doing that as we take in the images, but that's not that system not being used in this match. So that part of it wouldn't have mattered. But I would, you know, in my mind there, if you did review that, I don't think you could overturn that.
It was a great angle. Mm-hmm. I mean, it wasn't right down the end line. I guess that would be the perfect angle, but it was a pretty good angle from our crew, and they slowed it down as much as they could. So it's you got to have indisputable video evidence.
Is that one where only J.J. Tompkins knows? She ain't saying.
Well, she saved it.
I think she knows. I think she knows
goalie,
it wasn't. Yeah, I think she knows it was not a goal. And, of course, Washington State was vocal about that, as they should have been. That was whoever doesn't get that call is going to need to make some noise about it. But that's how close it was to being 2-1.
29, Alicia Overland, a redshirt junior from Moses Lake, Washington, has checked in. Bennett has checked out. Overland, a forward. Sophia Weiner, 24, and I don't want to leave her out of the mix. We were talking about freshmen along that backfield there for the Buffs. 24 is a redshirt freshman, but when you look at that Greening, the senior on the far side, and two true freshmen center backs, and then a fullback here on the near side, Weiner, a redshirt freshman. So very young back there, but very talented for this Buff squad.
I don't think, take inventory here. I don't think we've seen Kelsey Acness yet today. Kelsey is upper class, she's a junior, but another big time defender, has put in a lot of good minutes for the defense of the Buffaloes.
This is gonna be a corner kick for the Cougars. Waiting to see who goes over
yeah,
to take
the
kick.
Who's heading over there? Good investigative work by our crew in the control room. Sydney Pulver, the sophomore out of Regis Jesuit in Parker, Colorado, took that shot that we just showed you again that went off of Tompkins' hands and off the crossbar. That was Pulver on the shot. Nearly went in. Now the corner coming from the Cougars.
Haro is going to bend this one in. Into the middle of the box, up high. Was number 23, Minnis, Colorado native. She streaks back to get back on defense, but she had an opportunity there. Ended up sending it right to Tompkins. Let's take another look. Beautiful ball in. Coming right at you. Minnis. Just didn't get quite the touch on it, the header on it that she wanted. That was right to Tompkins.
Maddie Haro, number 19, the senior, took that corner for the Cougars, and she's the one we were talking about earlier. 9 assists on the season, tied with Taylor Korniak for number 1 in the Pac-12, number 2 in the NCAA with those 9 assists. Haro, left foot, so dangerous from the corner. Had a career-high 7 assists last season, did Haro, and she's already passed that mark this year with 9. In Haro's senior campaign.
And we mentioned how long it took, who was going to head over there, who was going to take it. And then after a ball like that, you're like, I'm sure there's no dispute.
Right.
Who
yeah, it wasn't like we were trying to decide. We know
right.
Who's going. I think they were waiting to kind of get themselves set up. And
right, just see which play they wanted to run at that point.
Time.
Right, but that was a beautiful corner. And you mentioned all the assists, 9, so certainly she's been setting up her teammates all season long.
Now, Haro, one of 5 awards from the Pac-12 earned by the Cougars so far this season on those weekly awards. Haro was the Defensive Player of the Week August 21 at the start of the season. There have been 16 awards made this season. Or I'm sorry, make that one 18 awards, I guess. There's been 6 weeks, and there every week there's an offensive, a defensive, and a goalkeeper of the week. So 18 across the entire conference, players have been awarded with weekly awards. 5 of those, 5 of the 18 have gone to Cougars. They've been chewing up the awards this year.
Well, I guess when you win 10 of your first 10, that's that's probably going to happen.
Doing some award-worthy things.
Certainly. The only untied team in the country right now, Washington State Cougars. However, they are down 2-0 to the Colorado Buffaloes, who are also unbeaten. A number of subs coming in for the Buffs.
Libby Garrity checking in, redshirt freshman from Cherry Creek High School. Greenwood Village also in is Stephanie Zuniga and Marty Pukitapu onto the pitch. And we're talking about corners. Let's get Zuniga one of those. She had that corner kick goal against Michigan State. Let's do that again, Stephanie.
That's one you'll remember forever.
And well, the other one you'll remember forever is Pukitapu on her 21st birthday scored a goal. She wears number 21, but she got a birthday goal on birthday number 21. We had a post-game interview with her. I believe she should be the post-game interview every, no matter what.
No
after
matter
volleyball
what
matches, after football, whatever, it should be Marty Pukitapu. She was phenomenal. She's got, you know, she's got the accent. She's from New Zealand. But she's got just great energy, great personality, and a lot of soccer talent on top of that. Marty's out there now getting her first look today.
And speaking of energy, Zuniga, 19, brings a lot of energy to the game. A little instant offense when she comes in. So it's somewhat of an embarrassment of riches when you're Danny Sanchez and you're bringing in some of these players off the bench. You brought in three players and they're all extremely talented and have got the job done in their own right each spot. So it's, you're talking about Garrity.
There's a slip down. There's that wet turf possibly coming into play.
Overland trying to get a shot just over the crossbar that time. The reserve forward into the contest and ripping that one. She does have two goals on the season.
Overland. Kaylee Webb lost her footing and that opened up a gap. Tompkins went up tall on this and just over the crossbar. Good opportunity for the Cougars.
Tompkins there able to cover if it was a little bit lower. That off the head of Korniak and out of play.
Finally figured it out. All season I've been looking. Here comes a couple of Cougar subs. We get right there. It's like Haley Smith, freshman forward coming in. And
Weaver subs out. Just one sub, 14 was
right.
Molly Myers.
Myers
was over, over here handling the ball as it went out of play there. Korniak going to be whistled for another foul as Overland goes down.
Korniak playing a physical game in this one. She went down in a heap a couple of times on opportunities in front of the offensive goal for the Buffaloes and put a lot of body on the Cougars too. She decided to come out and establish her presence. And you know, it's clean play, but it's physical play from Korniak.
No question about it. The Mac Herman watch list. Going to the top soccer player in the country as we've got a foul. This one going against Washington State. And Pukitapu, the player down right now for the Buffs. And quickly, the trainer coming out for CU.
Yeah, the official was asked Marty, do you need a trainer? And she shook her head yes quickly.
Just into the match.
Was on the Pac-12 all-freshman team last year, Marty Pukitapu led CU with 8 goals, 18 points. Was second in the Pac-12 last year in game-winning goals with 5 of those. And now in her sophomore year, a key contributor for Danny Sanchez, Marty Pukitapu being tended to now.
Brad Thompson, Thad Anderson here with you on Pac-12 Plus. It's 2-0, Buffs with the lead. We've got an injury stoppage going on right now as the Buffs head over to the bench to talk things over as the training staff checks out. Marty Pukitapu.
Marty, like she wants to sit up. I just hate to see this. Buffalo's had their share of not just injuries, but key injuries so far this year with Korniak going out, Greening out. They both returned, but got Cardenas out. Pukitapu not putting any weight on that left leg. Assisted off on each shoulder.
Come on, come on, come on. look. Foul. It's not what you want to see for anybody.
Man, it's been high-speed, aggressive play all day long. You just had two players converging on a ball right there. Washington State will sub. They're going to send in a freshman defender. Eleli Rebreza is on for Washington State. And you got for the Buffaloes, a replacement for Marty Pukitapu is a sophomore, Katie Joella out of Mountain Vista High School in Highlands Ranch, Colorado. Sophomore Katie Joella now on with Marty Pukitapu out due to injury.
Get the clock started again here as soon as Tompkins toes it.
What do you think, goal for JJ right here?
Well, both keepers have an assist. When you look at the stat sheet, Tompkins and Watson both have an assist on the season. This one's not going to have the distance.
You know, the breeze prevailing, well, it's more than a breeze. Down here, it feels like a breeze. If you look up top of the scoreboard, it's a wind. And you could see as soon as that ball got up for Tompkins, it just got knocked back down and started heading its way back toward her. Pretty stout wind up higher.
There's a look at the flags here at Prentup Field. Kinsler in the middle of the Korniak. She's got some room. Going to play it up ahead. Gary leaves this one in the middle, and it got punched out of there, trying to find Joella. It's going to go out of bounds. Garrity will leave it off. Garrity, the guest on This Week in Colorado Soccer, hosted by our producer, Eric Poloni. Check that out on Facebook every Monday. Coach Danny Sanchez is with Eric as this one's sent to Thompson. She handles that along the near post. And Libby Garrity was a guest this week on the show.
What do you think? Would Poloni be, what position would he take for us on an 11? Is he a goalkeeper, you think?
Could be a keeper. You know, could be a full left or right, maybe, in the backfield.
Got to get him in the alumni game. Got a bunch in town this weekend, right? Bunch of alums
hanging
out.
That's right. Alumni weekend for the women's soccer program. Washington, the Huskies, 2 p.m. on Sunday.
Now Washington sitting at two wins, one loss in conference right now. The Buffaloes at 1-0-2. You like not losing, but they talk about muddling up those standings right out of the box, get a couple of ties in. So Colorado up, in upper position in the conference right now with the 1-0-2. Washington State sitting at 3-0 in conference play. Stanford also up there atop the heap, but the battle already setting up nicely. It's a big weekend for Colorado soccer with the Washington schools coming through town.
Two great programs, the Huskies and the Cougars. That one's played out along the bleachers on the far side.
I was talking to some of the Cougars fans out at their tailgate, their large tailgate out in the parking lot today. They're talking about Washington State hasn't lost to the Huskies in 10 years. And they said it won't be this year. That string ain't in it this year.
That's remarkable when you think about that rivalry and how long the Cougars have been on top. And this year, again, seventh in the country, unbeaten, untied, 10-0. As we've got a foul, that's going to go against Kia McLean, sophomore from Long Beach, California.
McLean was the Pac-12 Defensive Player of the Week, September 25, yet another of the weekly awarded Cougars. That was Bauckham who went down. She took a moment to get up, but she's up and at it. Looks like she's coming out of that okay. The Buffaloes have a couple of subs ready. Nancy Best is waiting along with Cheney Kingsbury, so Best is a senior and Kingsbury a freshman. We'll get both ends of the class spectrum on the next sub in for the Buffaloes. Kingsbury a flip thrower, so let's get her a couple. That's always fun to watch.
Oh yeah, especially late in the half, a little extra pressure on the offense of the Buffs. We're approaching 5 minutes remaining here before the half. Garrity to Joella, working inside through traffic. Buffs were looking for a call there as Joella went down.
But Joella with some quick feet. She moves well, and I think they were all, everybody on the Buffalo side was looking for a stop, but no call came. Fresh legs, though, Joella recently in, and somebody can add a little pressure that Buffaloes have done a good job applying all throughout the first half.
Seen a number of subs for both teams, but certainly for Colorado, they've got a bunch of depth. Let's take another look as Joella trying to get through traffic there. The defender stopping the ball there initially and then got tangled up.
The Cougars, you're talking about depth. Cougars too deep at every position. They have 30 on the roster. They're here on the mountain swing, and so yeah, you can say what you want, but it does have an effect, the altitude, because they'll be in Salt Lake on Sunday. A couple of days off between matches, but that will play to the Cougars' benefit, not only on this mountain swing, but throughout the season, that deep roster they've got. And they'll deploy that today in this top 25 matchup. What a great start for Colorado today. They got their first goal at 1:21 into the clock, and then they got their second goal at 11:35 into the clock, and established themselves early, which they've done so often this year.
It's been that early offense. That has been the recipe for this Buff squad, scoring early and scoring often. And then, you know, some games they've kind of hung on or it's been a draw. Other games they've just blown out their opponents. A couple 6-0 victories.
Yeah, one in conference. It's Oregon State. It's Joella taking the ball.
She does look fresh. Look at her go through traffic there. Able to draw the foul.
Yeah, she did. Look at this. See this right after she kind of raises her arms like, it can't stop me. Get that whistle out. Only thing that stopped me is them grabbing me. It's work by Katie. You come in on an injury sub for Marty Pukitapu. And this is a great example of, you know, be ready when your moment comes. And Katie's presence has been well known since she arrived in place of Pukitapu.
On the whistle?
Yes, yes, thank you.
Korniak and Zuniga lining up this free kick. We'll see who takes it. The right foot of Taylor Korniak, the left foot of Stephanie Zuniga. Or maybe a combination. Korniak walks into it, drills it.
Great job, Molly.
Got deflected back out.
Ouch.
Greening couldn't come up with that one. It goes all the way back to Lauren. Let's take another look.
Maddie pulled off that one on the way in after she heard the thud of Korniak's foot. McLaughlin was fouled moments ago over here, and then there was some frustration mixed in with that one. Down went Akila McLean. Another nice crowd assembled. This is an early match on a Thursday in Boulder. And as usual, Buffaloes and the Cougars brought some fans today too. People got a little spirited on this last bit. We're gonna get a couple more minutes of play in the first half, and it looks like the intensity is gonna be high.
And that's what you'd expect between two top 20 programs here. This one's sent on, but well wide along the far side from Myers.
Taylor Korniak is out there laughing and head bobbing, talking to Jorian Bauckham. Here come Best and Kingsbury. Bauckham's going to leave, as is Sarah Kinsner. We have Katie Jones, the junior for Washington State, was also waiting to check in. She's on now.
Bauckham comes out. The second goal of the day for the Buffs. Very early on, if you're just joining us, the Buffs made it 2-0. It was 1-0 after less than 2 minutes of play. Then in the 12th minute, Jorian Bauckham made it 2-0. And the Cougars have had some chances, two off the post, one crossbar, one near post, and the bounce did not go their way. Now we've got under 60 seconds remain here before halftime. Throw in all the way into the box. Haley Smith, a freshman from San Jose, California, 17, recently into the contest. Not a flip throw, but able to get the distance on that one in deep there, all the way from the sideline. Now Tompkins across midfield.
Great
Buffalo's trying to mount one more attack here, about 15 seconds left before the halftime horn. Colorado leading 2-0 on top of the visiting Washington State Cougars.
Final few seconds here of the first half. There's the horn after 45 minutes of action here from Boulder. The 20th ranked Colorado Buffaloes 2, the 7th ranked Washington State Cougars 0. Korniak and Baucom, your 2 goal scorers for the Buffaloes. And the fans enjoying a 2-0 Buffs.
So the first 250 fans get a free print glass. Also, Ralphie will be here to run pregame. Make sure you get here early. Purchase your tickets at cubus.com/tickets or by calling 303-49-BUFF. Don't forget, it's 12 and under and in for free. And fans, if the Buffs win and you win, get loud and cheer on the Buffs to victory to get free Qdoba chips and pizza with an entree purchase. The University of Colorado and Buffalo Sports Properties would like to thank the following sponsors for their continued support of Colorado soccer. Gatorade, Muscle Milk, Nike, Pepsi, State Farm, and Nissan.
halftime here at Prentice Hub Field. The Cougars and the Buffaloes, 2-0 Colorado. Let's see how we got there very early on for the Buffaloes. In fact, a minute 21 seconds in. Taylor Korniak off the corner from Aaron Greening.
Great start for the Buffaloes. Great ball from Greening and Korniak. You mentioned it, Brad. A little more space there for Taylor than I think the Cougars coaching staff was looking for. Taylor will not miss getting an opportunity like that.
Seeing her come into the picture there. Not much Rachel Thompson can do. Now Thompson this time gave up a rebound. And Dorian Balcom able to put that in. That was the 12th minute. And Tatum Barton also got an assist there.
Swiss Army knife, array of weapons by Balcom as she handled the ball well off the goalkeeper, mishandled, redirected, controlled. I mean, she did a little bit of everything there. To watch her athleticism and ball handling is, that's a huge addition for CU after transferring from LSU. Balcom scored.
Look at the first half stats. Shots on goal, what jumps out very even. The fouls, it's been an intense game and a couple of saves from JJ Tompkins for the Buffs, but quickly back to action here in the second half.
Look at that, shots on goal, 2 for Washington State, and not just shots on goal, but shots in goal for Colorado. They had 2 on goal and they both went in. The Buffaloes this year, when leading at halftime, 8-0-1. Of course, neither team has a loss on their ledger yet this year. How about that? I mean, you got 21 matches between the two of them played, or 22 or whatever we got now. Not a loss. So somebody today potentially could get their first of the season. Colorado in great position. Balcom liked their opportunity there and misfired.
Thompson comes out with it. And if you're Washington State, you haven't given up 2 goals all season. You've given up 2 in the first half here to the Buffaloes, but on the flip side, you've got the firepower, you've got the weapons to get right back in this one. And not knowing what the message was in halftime, you assume let's get, be aggressive early, maybe get one in the back of the net and kind of level that playing field, get within one. But the danger there is if you give the Buffs an opportunity here, you cannot let them get another goal, period, at this point. So we'll see how much aggression the Cougars have. Right now, it's Colorado in the first minute or so here. It's a little bit more aggressive than Washington State pressing the issue right now.
Foul from the Cougars. Buffaloes play it toward the scoring goal. The trending, I guess, the momentum feel for Washington State. They gave up those 2 goals early in the first half, 1:21 and 11:35 on the clock. I mean, I think that's one thing you talk about on Todd Schulenberger's side is, okay, we stabilized. Now we're just going to kind of tilt it the other way and start taking control here. This ball is going to be a little too deep coming in from Greening. And, you know, Colorado, I imagine for Danny Sanchez, I would think the message probably was, let's play this like a first half. Let's don't get defensive here. Let's don't try to sort of milk a lead and protect the lead. Because Washington State, as you said, they've got a lot of weapons. They can come at you. So Colorado, I think, is going to want to keep the attitude. And it looks like they are so far here in the second half of, we're taking the game to them and see if we can get another early one and a half here to continue to build the advantage on the Cougars.
And the intensity ratcheted up late in the first half. And so both teams kind of coming out with that right now here in the second half. It's obviously two of the top programs in the country. We're talking about 2 top 20 teams and both teams unbeaten coming in. So both teams used to having success, the Buffaloes right now with the lead in control 2-0, but Washington State with a lot of offense can get right back in it. Perhaps the best play for Colorado, keep that their offense going and keep the Cougars on the heels worrying about the offense of Colorado. But right now Weaver's got a chance. She's gonna bend that one in with the left foot. It was along the ground. Might not have been quite the strike that she wanted to get on it as this one's outletted on the far side to Grork. I'm not sure she saw that one until there was a player on her there and played it out of bounds.
Throw from Sophia Weiner, the redshirt freshman who redshirted last year at Virginia out of Evergreen, Colorado. Weiner, a lot of time for Danny Sanchez. She handled that throw. That's what sends us over.
One of the three freshmen along that back line for the Buffs we're talking about. They've outscored opponents 36-5 on the season. And right now they've had some injuries along that back line, but they've had three freshmen, one redshirt and two true freshmen along that back line defensively. And it's been very stout and very solid back there. And obviously Tompkins has a lot to do with that in goal.
Washington State, five shutouts and 5-1 goal allowed games. So they've allowed five goals for the season. I mean, if you're a play on the offensive side, play on the defensive side, like video game stuff for both of these programs through the first portion of the season. And Washington State, the only ranked team they had played before today, UCLA was number 8 when the Cougars beat UCLA at Los Angeles. For Colorado, this is the first ranked opponent they've seen this year. And to this point, Colorado answering the call. You know, Danny Sanchez said after the Arizona trip where they got two draws, we have to get bigger results. I mean, I think if you go on the road, you know, not losing is a good thing. We played well. And the way the matches played out, he said he thought draws were appropriate. The teams played even matches. But he also said, we get it. We have to get bigger results in matches like that. Colorado's RPI not in great shape right now, but that'll, of course, just continue to rise through Pac-12 play.
Bennett running on now as Tompkins came out. The whistle came late, but that will be a foul. Webb went down, and Bennett going to be the guilty party here.
Well, for a shutout intact at this point for Colorado, I think J.J. Tompkins has had as much adrenaline rush today as she's had yet this season. There have been a number of plays like this where J.J.'s had to really activate.
See the contact from Bennett on Webb, and Tompkins back there to take the kick. 5'6", redshirt junior from Phoenix, Arizona, one of the captains.
Oh, are you kidding? Now the wind turned around on her. They switched sides and the wind's not blowing the way it was in her face before, the opposite direction. Not getting the atmospheric breaks to this point.
Gomera Stevens trying to play that through. It got pinballed around there. Kornack trying to come out with it. This one got deflected back though. Clark played that up ahead. Now it's back. Pulver near side to Weaver. Weaver the leading scorer at 14 points on the season. And she's going to earn a corner kick there. She was able to turn the corner a little bit, working on greening. And Lauren able to come over and play it out. But a corner kick coming up here for the visiting Cougars.
Jesse Lauren made the run. Again, that's a senior freshman combo on defense with Greening battling and then Lauren coming off the backside. Did the right thing, just got rid of that. The defense reset.
This one sent in. It's trying to get punched out. It's still loose in front. And somehow the Buffs keep that one from growing across the line. My goodness.
Cougars were celebrating on their side over here under the tent. Thought they had it in. I think he got another crossbar contact.
We'll take another look at it. Tompkins trying to get a hand on it. Went off the crossbar of Weaver. Touched there by Korniak. And then punched out of there. Weiner able to clear it. But again, a tough break for the Cougars off the crossbar that time.
Sophia Weiner, right place, right time. That was headed to the net. Weiner, last line of defense, got it done. There's another adrenaline rush for Tompkins and the defense of the Buffaloes. Cougars twice now thought they had goals. Once previously they thought so even more than that. But yeah, from down here on this side, long look at that. I thought the score was done. Buffaloes dodge another one.
Massey with the ball. On the far side to Grork, too much expected there.
How about those corners? Maddie Haro, you know, she's the assist queen. I mean, that's what she does, the left foot out of that corner. But man, that's the way she's put the ball in a couple times today. You don't want to see her over there again.
No, yeah, if you're on that back line for the Buffs, you're thinking, do whatever we can to not get a corner kick here.
Get the corners on the other side, on the far side. Here's a good ball to the net and saved by Thompson.
Balkum now to Barton. That one trickling across the box and then sent out.
Rourke held it in, but Washington State's going to get a chance to push it away now. Attack mounted by the Buffaloes. They needed that. They need to sustain that. They're under pressure here.
Kinsner now attacking. Chips one up ahead, and no run being made there by any Buffaloes.
Goalkeeper for Washington State, by the way, Rachel Thompson, the redshirt junior who took over for Ella Diedrich. And Rachel hung up that shutout at UCLA. She was in goal for that 1-0 win. She's out of Alaska, a diverse roster for Washington State. Love the distribution on this thing. Of course, when you got 30 players, you're going to have a little representation.
But
bringing them from all around. They got them from a lot of the pedigree states, but also Coach Schulenberger, he finds them in a lot of spots with a big push. They got Korniak. Cougars raising the point that that's Taylor Korniak. She's showing, compared to what I saw from her earlier this season, of course, in non-conference, showing a little different gear of physicality in this one with Washington State.
She's ratcheted up a little bit, certainly. And that's part of her game, if you've seen her play in the past. But yeah, it looks to be at a different level right now with Korniak. And
well, now a junior, I think she's in that spot. Your ball coming in. She's in that spot now where it's, okay, now it's my time. I'm going to dictate some things.
And you're right, understanding it, being an upperclassman, understanding this is a huge game. You've got the seventh-ranked team. They're unbeaten, untied, coming into Prentup Field. If not now, when? You know, this is the time to leave it out here. And on the field here at Prentup, 2-0 right now, Colorado.
Checking back in my notes because I'm sure it's where it was. Cougars were picked to finish seventh in the conference this year, right? And last year they did finish seventh. They went 10-8-4 overall, 4-6-1 in conference, finished seventh, went to the third round, the Sweet 16 of the NCAA tournament. But again, they were picked to go seventh this year.
And 3-0 as officials talking this one over.
Frustration from Makamai Gomera-Stevens. She was wiped out. You know, part of what was bad about that for Gomera-Stevens was that she landed on the ball, and so the end of it was a little more violent than it would have been, but she was frustrated with Greening. She spiked the ball. She got a word from our referee saying we better hold things together here. The bench, too, for Washington State. Now, I'm not going to fault them for what they're doing, but they are displeased with a variety of events. Frustration for the Cougars, and most recently Gomera-Stevens went down hard. This ball goes to the Buffaloes.
Greening, who went out against Colorado State, back against Arizona State. She's going to take this free kick towards the top of the box, trying to find Korniak, and the Cougars able to go up high and win that ball.
So you don't look like him, but you know that the logo image for the Scott Van Pelt Sports Center show, that is his head image?
Yeah, with the headset. Oh, yes.
So right now on our monitor, the sun shining from behind you, you have a very majestic headset head. All I can see is the silhouette. Can you see that?
I certainly can.
Are you proud of your
look?
Yes. Are you proud of that?
I'm sorry that people at home can't see that.
No, I wish we could share that look across. You've got great headset silhouette.
The sun setting to our west behind us.
So most of what I can see on the monitor right now is just your head shadow.
I do have hair though.
Where's
Scott Van Pelt?
True. Wherever you lean, I can see that part of the monitor. So if you would just kind of keep
just
moving around.
Keep the ball.
It's a viewfinder.
Ball in the shadows here.
A bright sunny day after all that rain. Nasty clouds came through in Boulder.
This one's sent across, and the Cougars find the back of the net. Morgan Weaver, leading scorer for Washington State. Able to make that one count. They've been unlucky up until this point, and Washington State puts that one in, cuts this deficit in half.
It's been a frame job today for the Cougars, again off the post. Bang from the far side of that shot, and then back across, and wow, that's the third time they've hit the frame, and this one finds its way home.
Weaver, 7 goals now on the season, 16 points. Those both lead, both categories lead the team for the Cougars.
Or the Bruins did Morgan Weaver. University plays Washington. She had that game-winning goal. Here she has the goal to cut the lead in half. Now the Buffaloes under some pressure with Washington State immediately putting it back in the attack half.
Bennett plays it across, shot from the outside, got blocked. That's Clark trying to get it past Tompkins. She cannot. But a different feel all of a sudden right now for the Cougars. And of course, we're right next to their bench, so we can hear and feel the energy coming from them as Clark tried to sneak that one past Tompkins.
Some good carry on that kick by Tompkins. She got into one, and Barton trying to get control for the Buffaloes.
Gomera Stevens into the middle. And Gwork able to step in front, take it away. Racing the other way. Baucom to her right side. She plays it out there. Baucom trying to get past one defender. Cannot. Well done defensively. McLean there.
It's Maddie Harrow approaching the ball, the assist maker for the Cougars.
Aaron, go. Just
near side,
Gomera
Stevens has some room.
Emily.
Plays it in, off the head of Weaver, and right there is J.J. Tompkins. What a pass and a setup, the buildup there for Washington State. They're starting to feel it right now. They're making some plays, but Tompkins able to stop it.
Got loose behind the defense, great ball in. Great save by Tompkins. She was frustrated a moment ago on that goal that Cougars scored. And that's what you got to do. You got to wipe it clean. Doesn't matter. Still up 2-1 because of that save. Nice play by Tompkins.
And judging by Weaver's reaction there, she already has one goal just a few minutes ago. Didn't quite get the touch off the head there that perhaps she wanted. Sent it down a little bit too much, perhaps. Made it just easy enough for Tompkins, but certainly credit Tompkins for being in the right spot and reading that well.
Yeah, good read on the angle by Tompkins. She was centered on that.
Greening
making the run.
Yeah, running all the way down here, trying to keep it in bounds. We've seen this from her before. Now that right foot, and really not a lot of support there from the Buffs. Baucom, the only one in the box.
This has the feel right now of kind of a final 10-minute battle, but we've still got 28 minutes clock time to go, but the intensity is ratcheted up and likely to, as it was in the first half, likely to just sustain all the way down. You can feel the edge on both sides and out between the lines right now. Full go at this point. Each team going to send in two subs.
Jesse away.
Few moments.
Yeah, back door, so Jesse, go. Yeah, Kaylee four.
Maddie Harrow was credited with the assist. She's now in double figures with 10 on that last goal, a first goal for the Cougars as a couple of subs come in.
Harrow, 10th assist. That puts her ahead of Taylor Korniak. They were tied for number two in the NCAA with 9 assists into today. And Harrow continues to set up teammates.
Jess, come right here. Jess, come corner D. Yeah, Taylor four.
Long throw in here for the Cougars.
Away! Back door up top.
They have had the ball in front of the goal for a large portion of the second half. Did it again there. Buffalo's defense under duress.
This one played on. Tompkins sprawling. Able to come up with that one on far side, right near the post.
Yet again showcasing why she's on the All-Pac-12 hair team. A little extra flair on those saves. Tompkins, she's a, everything she does is, you know, fundamental, dynamic. A blast to watch. She frustrated that one that got by her redshirt junior, Jalen J.J. Tompkins. She's going to be taking the heat here for the rest of this one. I mean, even if the Buffaloes can get the ball into their attack half, they're going to see the Cougars coming at them, and you can see the mean, we talked about early about all the talent on the field. You're seeing it both ways now, and there's so many players who can make a difference on any ball.
A number of great scoring opportunities here this afternoon for both teams. A little too much on that one. It's going to go over to Coach Danny Sanchez. In the shadows here at Prenta Field. Greening will take the throw in, and the Buffs to start the second half for the first few minutes, supplying some pressure, being aggressive, but then the Cougars with a number of chances, an unlucky one first off the crossbar, but then Weaver able to put it in the back of the net and a couple chances since then. So Cougars with the momentum right now, mid second half. Both teams walking ahead here into the sun as Greening is going to put it down right near the midfield stripe. Korniak has been the target on most of these. She is, again, able to play it on Grork. I don't think got a good read on, excuse me, that's Libby Garrity, number 7, on the far side there for the Buffs. Barton almost able to make a play. Baucom playing it up ahead to Garrity.
Barton, top goal scorer in the Pac-12 with 11 on the season. Buffalo's working to get her loose in front of the goal.
Yeah, we haven't heard much from her when you're talking about 11 goals on the season. And like Baucom, a product of the players around her and helped out by Korniak. And as she shows off some beautiful skills here near midfield, she gets it up to Barton. Out to the far side, Garrity, and here come the Buffs. Barton, that time, trying to line that one up. It got sent back out. Garrity able to track it down. Tries to send in the cross, got deflected. Now the left foot, and that one headed out of there.
Comes Greening to keep it in. A little battle for Greening on a speed approach by Elise Bennett.
No. 29 coming in. Overland, a forward. And Ebony Clark, number 4, subs out.
So we play in the 66th minute. We talked before about the depth of these rosters. You're going to see who's got what left in the tank at this point. I don't think you're going to see any drop off on either side, either from the starters and the frontliners or anybody you see come off the bench at this point. This could be November, December soccer here that you're going to see down the last 20 plus minutes.
A heel flick there from Baucom trying to set up Garrity. Almost a sensational connection. Kingsbury coming back in. Chaney Kingsbury, freshman from Windsor, 4A player of the year and state champ from a season ago.
Tallied a hat trick in the state championship match against Valor Christian. How about that for
a send-off?
Memory and a bio line.
A way to finish up your high school career. Barton subs out.
Leaving no doubt about state player of the year. She's got that flip throw, Chaney.
Utilizing it there.
Actually, that was interesting. Saw that happen earlier this season. Chaney on a flip throw, ball came right back to her, and she scored off of the deflection back at her. She had probably a flashback just now. That ball came right back at her off the sideline.
And you get right into the game. You get into the action. You get the flip throw. The ball comes right back. Get a couple touches. As Baucom, not the header she wanted there, sent it wide on the far side. And didn't threaten Thompson. Now this one's a little bit short, but the back line able to punch it out of there, but Zuniga sends it back up. Baucom gets tangled up there.
This point in the match, you got to get up. See a few players looking around asking for a call, and you got to keep going. Got a call coming, it's coming. It's not much time to leave gaps or give opportunities to the other side.
And in a match where it's this intense, this much on the line, this much physicality going on, certainly that's going to happen. Some of it you got to play through. But to get up looking for the foul, you got to know that you're not going to get the call on a lot of these. This one now to Kingsbury. She's got some room. Tries to go outside. That one was deflected. Can she track it down? Now It rolls across the line, goal kick here for Washington State.
McLean had the defense on Kingsbury. We've seen a handful of different situations with Akilah McLean, the sophomore who has a Defensive Player of the Week honor this season. She's had an impact at defensive half.
Yeah, she's been up to the challenge, particularly here in the second half where there were a few more opportunities. And she's just said, no thanks. I don't want any part of that. I could stop this right now. So she has picked it up here in the second half. McLean, who we're talking about, number 20 along that back line for the Cougars.
Talking about depth, this is going to be a first-time check-in here. Kelise Barton, the freshman for Washington State. And that's what you're talking about. You're talking about depth. You get to this point in the match, it's this tight. You bring in a fresh freshman off the bench. But it's because you have confidence in your entire roster. Time to get some new legs in there.
Gary DeBalcom, and just a bit wide. Let's take another look at that. Garrity. And Balcom just couldn't get the touch on it. Swing and a miss there.
Off angle coming out was Rachel Thompson. She's got a tough sun on her right now. You can see her shielding her eyes there after that ball went out. Just another factor here Buffaloes can keep in mind, keeping pressure on the goal.
Zuniga, some fancy footwork, retreating now, plays it near side to Greening. She's gonna send that one all the way across. Zuniga got turned around, but they couldn't clear it out. It was tantalizingly just sitting there. As this one's played across, Thompson coming out, goes up high to get it, but there was a moment there, it's like in football or something, where the fumble, nobody sees it. The ball got deflected there, ended up just hitting the turf, and nobody initially reacted.
Yeah, there were three defenders around it for the Cougars. I don't think the Buffaloes realized that the ball was lost by the defenders. The Buffaloes could have attacked that easily. I think they were assuming the play was easily handled by the Cougars. Nervous moments, that's coaching staff perspective, that's stuff you think, oh, you can coach everything you want and get one of those.
Two goals for Colorado in the first half, one goal for the Cougars here in the second half, and that's how we're at 2-1. 71st minute here from Boulder, Colorado on Pac-12 Plus. Thad Anderson along with Brad Thompson here. And a beautiful day, and it is getting a little cooler out here as the shadows get longer across the field and the sun continues to go down. Shot from the outside, a little bit high that time.
It came from Brianna Alger from Monument, Colorado. Lewis Palmer High School is where Brianna played her high school soccer. Colorado kid almost tied up Colorado. It's 2-1 Buffaloes again, defending against stream onslaught here from the Cougars.
Balcom comes out as she's going to get a breather over here along the bench for the Buffaloes.
It'll probably be the last breather for Balcom, and then going to reinsert her down the stretch. Chess match breaking out now. Haley Smith, freshman from San Jose for the Cougars, is waiting to sub in.
Myers fouled there by Korniak. Barton fresh into the game, sends this one in deep, run on there, almost the connection. Dangerous play there.
Katie Jones ended up in the goal, or not? Was that Katie, or was that that run in? No, that wasn't Katie, that was Elise Bennett. She ends up in the goal. Head to it. Talk about taking her momentum through the ball. She went where she wanted it to go, just barely off on the timing for the Cougars.
Haley Smith, number 17, back in there for Washington State. And Bennett, the sophomore, gets a breather, much like Balcom. Getting a breather here late, and we'll be right back in there to be able to finish strong. But you talked about it, there's been no drop off in the skill level. We've seen a number of substitutions, and this game's still very wide open. It's back and forth opportunities. on both ends. There's a late challenge there from Smith, and she's gonna get called every time for that one. You look up ahead though, you've got Kingsbury 14 up there, Groark's now up top for the Buffs. Zuniga up high, Garrity also the attacking midfield is Korniak up there now, thought about it with the left foot, plays it out wide, Groark. And the point I was trying to make there, other than Korniak, you're looking at all reserves, all subs that have come in on the offensive end here for Colorado. Zuniga, Garrity. Now Kingsbury's going to come off and Barton going to come back on, and we're going to start to see some of the starters back out there. But there has been no drop-off, and it's the confidence that Coach Sanchez has in his bench, the depth that this team has, the competition they have in practice, knowing I can put a bunch of different players in there and get results and get production, even if they're not the starters, and that's impressive to see.
You just saw the conference's leading goal scorer come on, as you mentioned, Tatum Barton back in.
Buffaloes.
I'd love nothing better than to take a little edge off of this one, beaten by just a goal. They've had a few chances of late, and now going to have to defend.
Now plays it back, sustained possession here for the Cougars. Barton going to send that ball in. And on the hop, Tompkins able to handle it.
Cougars a team that they have not tasted defeat or draw this season in 10 matches. This is a new situation for them, a new position that they're in now, playing in the 76th minute. Trying to get Katie Jones checked in over here for Washington State, and she's told she had to go back and some kind of an adjustment had to be made, medical or uniform adjustment. And been stuck over here trying to get herself eligible to get into the match. I think it's, you know, I think it's a piercing question, an ear piercing question. They're having to try to get her game legal. So that's put a little dent in the sub rotation.
Goal side, goal side, step, 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 step.
Myers plays it into the middle, top of the box. Nobody there except Buffaloes. Played up ahead to Barton.
Megan Massey is waiting to check in for Colorado. Senior Massey, a key cog for the Buffaloes.
Zuniga, big left foot, popping it up. Clint able to trap it there, and no pressure from Colorado. You talked about the unfamiliar position here for the Cougars. Undefeated, unbeaten, and they're on the road. They've only played 3 road games this season. 3-0, obviously, on the road, but Haven't had to travel a whole lot.
That's interesting. As a fall sport in Pullman, you can do that. If you're a spring sport, like baseball, you're on the road for your first 40 games until it warms up.
Opposite side of the spectrum there.
Colorado, the test is sturdy today. They're going to see Washington on Sunday, and they're going to expend a lot today to see if they can hold on to this 2-1 lead. They led 2-0 in the 12th minute, and now they've been, I don't know if I'd say on their heels, but they've spent time on their heels, if not, you know, been on their heels fully. Colorado, the stiffest challenge of the year on paper before today, and playing out that way on the turf.
Barton able to send that one out near midfield, and we've talked about how dangerous this Cougars team is on corners, and that one not quite the threat that it has been in the past. Number 3, Makamai Gomera Stevens back in there as Molly Myers subbed out during that corner.
Good.
And we're looking at another corner here.
Good acceleration by Haley Smith. Moves quickly with the ball, the freshman from San Jose for the Cougars. That's part of it. Colorado with the difficulty on defense here. Look at speed, acceleration for this Cougars team. You know, you got to worry about the ball, but first you got to worry about catching up. Cougars fast with the ball.
Weaver going to take it this time. Plays it short, and Greeny, not the touch that she wanted. Maddie Haro not in there right now. She's getting a breather over here on the Washington State bench.
Yeah, she would be the weapon right now in that corner.
He's got 20, Sarah, you got both.
That's Morgan foot. Weaver, the goal scorer for the Cougars. And Smith is going to come over and take it now. This one played through the box, now headed on. A shot off the post. Washington State has been extremely unlucky when you're talking about scoring opportunities off the post. Two solid strikes off the post, two off the crossbar. None of those resulting in a goal.
The goal that went in hit the post.
Matt, go.
Ricocheted across.
Libby!
That one
Libby
was,
10.
You know, I think it got the inside of the post. I mean, it wasn't close to being not a goal, but
no.
Everything they've done at the edges.
All over the frame. Tompkins, and credit her, obviously, she's had some
Emily
coverage there. She knows exactly how much.
Emily, Jim gets six.
This one.
Emily, nine.
Deflected. That replay did not appear to hit the post.
Yeah, it looked like bodies got in front of that one.
Cornyak trying to head that one out of there.
That was a good ball in by Kelly Spartan. She's a freshman. We talked about her just checked in, getting her first time of the day. She set up the attack nicely.
Dribble, dribble!
Grort goes down.
Jesse Wright.
On, good aggressive physical
Aaron
action.
Aaron Middle.
Oh, down to the turf, and there's an ankle grab. We're gonna have a moment here. That's Jesse Lauren. Banged up on the play. Cougars screaming to stop the clock as it runs up at 8:18, now 8:20.
Lauren, the freshman from Redondo Beach, California, back up on her feet.
No clock stoppage there. Washington State displeased with that decision as timer runs on. Jordan Bauckham waiting to come back in. And for Washington State, Maddie Harrow and Elise Bennett waiting to come in. Some of the original starters will be back on.
A couple of subs coming in here for the Cougars. Bennett, as you mentioned, and Harrow back out there. Bauckham also coming back in for Colorado as Garrity subs out. Smith and Algier come out for the Cougars. Greening with a thrown at midfield. To Massey and now to Weaver.
Lack of ball control there for the Buffaloes could put them in a spot here. Tompkins comes out to chip that away.
Barton versus Barton here when you look at 51 and 23. On the offensive end and defensive end, respectively, for Washington, or Colorado and Washington State. Massey making a run. She's open on the far side. She's got it here in the box, trying to get it past the keeper. First shot, no. Ooh. Second shot, it's in. 3-1, Colorado.
Megan Massey, well set up by the Buffaloes. Good initial stop by Rachel Thompson, but she wasn't able to control it. Massey works herself to a second opportunity. What a huge goal for the Buffaloes in the 82nd minute, giving them a two-goal cushion against the number 7 ranked Cougars of Washington State.
Second goal of the season for Megan Massey, the senior from Highlands Ranch. Coming up huge. Could see that play developing. As Massey was unmarked, credit Thompson for making the initial save. 82nd minute, Megan Massey coming through. Mountain Vista High School product, originally going to Tennessee. Hit a game-winning goal against Marquette and a second goal of the season here in this one. Makes it 3-1 and some breathing room for Colorado.
Yeah, there's the game-winning goal category. Is there a stress-relieving goal category? Because that took a massive amount of pressure off the Buffaloes. They've been under attack. J.J. Tompkins doing everything she can. Allowed one goal in the half here. And it was a long drought for the Buffaloes after two quick strikes in this one. Their second goal of the first half coming at 11:35. And then Washington State tilting the momentum. In the 58th minute, they got their goal. That was a major turn
Emily, she's coming.
Of status on that Massey goal.
This one sent in. No threat there. Gomera Stevens.
It's out in the parking lot. Libby Garrity back in for Colorado, and Jamie Rita, sophomore from Burien, Washington, on for the Cougars.
Hey, Jeff, 7 minutes.
Again, Colorado playing their first ranked opponent of the season, number 7, Washington State. They'll have the Huskies on Sunday and then host Oregon next Saturday. So 3 consecutive home matches for Colorado before they go out to Northern California with Cal and Stanford in a couple of weeks. They finish with 3 home matches, the Buffaloes, with USC and UCLA and then Utah. Starting off with 3 road matches and coming out at 1-0-2. Pay off down the line as they're going to have a tilted toward a home slate down the stretch. And this would be a huge win in their conference home opener. They played 3 on the road. Now this is the first time at home for the Buffs. Up 3-1 with the clock frozen at 83:59.
And Thad, to your point, counting today 6 of 8 here to finish the season at Prentup, a huge advantage, not just with the altitude, but a great crowd base. Fans here showing off, supporting and cheering on the Buffaloes. And I'm sure Coach Sanchez happy to have all those home matches coming up.
You talk about the altitude and just general home field. By the way, commendation to Washington State lower soccer field where they play at, just big renovation there. They've got a nice facility in Pullman now. So you, the different factors that are advantages, the weather is that one. You know, the Arizona schools,
yeah, back door.
Just went down there. The SoCal schools will be here as Tompkins eats one up in front of the goal. So the SoCal schools will be here. Maybe a little weather advantage down the stretch, too. It might be a little brisk for the USC and UCLA sides. Tompkins again, patrolling net. Not nearly the pressure as some of the attacks, saves, assaults put on here by Washington State have been very high pressure. A little better controlled by the defense. Getting a ball to Tompkins, it was pretty playable. This is a testament, though, to, you know, we're talking about all this talent out here and how good these teams are. The duress created for the CU defense by Washington State. If the Cougars don't win this, and it looks like they'd have to pull off a miracle to do it, they've proven what they're capable of just alone, the way they've worked the defense of Colorado. They've created brand new challenges that the Buffs haven't seen yet this year.
For Tompkins, I've got her down for 9 saves in this one. That one sent in, punched out there by Thompson, who's having to deal with the sun as it's setting to the west here.
She was shading her eyes again just now as Bauckham works with it to Korniak.
Korniak trying to keep it alive. It got deflected out. Massey is down here in the shadows. That ball's not going to go out of bounds. Massey back on her feet. That's a good sign. One of the goal scorers for Colorado, the latest goal scorer.
Second ball. Massey was back up. She was a little hindered for a moment. She looks like maybe it's shaking that off now, moving at regular speed. You don't want anybody down in speed or agility at this stage. 87th minute.
Need everybody at peak performance here to close this thing out. 3-1, Colorado with the lead over the 7th-ranked, unbeaten, untied Washington State Cougars. Greening lines this one up, sends it in. That's over the head of Korniak, but now she gets it on the rebound. The shot from the outside. Thompson with a beautiful save.
Corner for the Buffaloes. Is Zuniga still out there? She check out. Zuniga would be your corner.
That one came right to Korniak. And if you're the Cougars, that's not who you want to see able to control it at the top of the box there. But Thompson with that left glove able to deflect it just enough.
This will be Groark on the corner for Colorado.
This one on top of the netting there over the crossbar, and quickly Washington State going to get this ball down and the goal kick on its way as they're running out of time here. Kinsner chops that one up to Korniak. under 2.5 here to play for Prenta Field. Temperatures dropping as that sun continues to set, but right now, the Buffs, all they're concerned about is running this clock down and hearing that final horn.
We talked about the Buffaloes keeping the aggressiveness up, keeping the attack up. Now they can settle into defend mode and milk the clock mode. Clock holds at 88-12. And that's for an injured Cougar, Micaiah Minnis from Doherty High School in Colorado Springs. She's down right now, tending to Minnis. Buffalo's on hold right now, as are the Cougars. Injury check. Talked earlier about the five D1 programs who don't have a loss yet, and only one of those didn't have a tie either. That was Washington State. The unbeatens in NCAA Division I, Stanford, Washington State, and CU, three of the five from the Pac-12, also Georgetown and UC Riverside, the five unbeaten programs. And again, Washington State, the only one of those also without a tie. And but for one of the most stunning two-goal endeavors here by a road team in the history of NCAA soccer, Washington State looking at the wrong side of this outcome. Micaiah Minnis, enjoyed watching her play today. Minnis, just a freshman for the Cougars, came out of Doherty High School last year, had played every minute as a freshman for fourth-year head coach Todd Schulenberger this season. The only player on the roster to do that, by the way. That speaks very highly of Micaiah, and she is in need of help to get off. We saw Marty Pukitapu go off the same way, left leg, no weight on it earlier in this match. Hey, you know
what to do. No. Pukitapu we have not seen since, and we did see her walking under her own power at halftime, so that was a good sign from Marty. Let's hope for Minnis it's a similar situation, and it's not too serious. Chris Lang, athletic trainer for the Cougars out there, helped her off.
Aaron Mann, flick it behind. Yeah,
there
so
goes
fast.
Morgan Weaver running on this ball. It's been important for the Buffaloes today, trying to control her. She did get the only goal of the day for the Cougars. Weaver assisted by Haro.
Emily, go, you gotta go.
Cornett, Baucom, and Massey, the three goal scorers for the Buffaloes. Two in the first half, it was 2-0 at halftime. Final minute here. Cougars, no quitting them. They're trying to keep it alive. You never know here late. And final run in. Weiner, and will deflect it. And now Grohr sends it back to Weiner. That one punched up ahead and eventually spins out of bounds near midfield.
Taylor, you got the middle.
The Huskies and here for the women's soccer program. Tons of familiar faces that you're used to seeing out here at Prenta Field will be in attendance. Come on out and join us here at Prenta Field for that one against the Huskies. Another big matchup for Colorado. Final seconds ticking off here. That one's just going to spin toward midfield. There's the horn. The Buffaloes win it 3-1, an impressive fashion over the visiting Washington State Cougars. 2-0 at halftime, 3-1 the final. The Buffaloes remain unbeaten, 10-0-3 on the season now. and 2-0-2 in Pac-12 play. A big win for the Buffaloes over the 7th-ranked Cougars. Colorado wins it 3-1.